wife's begun to pack. Just another night, trying to turn a bob. Things go on like this. Have to get a job.
We present O'Rourke's First Case by Vincent McInerney, with Ken Cumberlidge as John O'Rourke.
John? John?
Hello, Dad.
What happened?
The job. Same as usually happens. I didn't get it.
Who did?
Ah, some young fella. More pens in his top pocket than the mad professor and a file of facts under his arm.
I thought you were in with the chance this time, getting an interview.
So did I. Till I got there. Then I became a 40-year-old redundant fitter from a bedding factory that was obsolete the day it was built.
What are you reading? One of those detective yarns of yours?
The truth was, apart from the fact that I'm white, I was your token black. At least you got a full working life at sea.
Young Curly and I have been waiting up the pub. Fancy one?
Curly. Now there's another one. 22 and never sniffed a job yet.
Never sniff a pint if we don't get up there before 3.
20 years I worked in that dump. Took the money. Now I'm supposed to sit here being consoled by Benny Hill. Well, I won't do it.
What will you do?
This.
Build a publishing empire?
Become a private eye.
Holmes! I should have guessed.
But you didn't.
Curly, I mean, he's been obsessed with that detective stuff since he was a lad. But I never thought he'd start to confuse fact with fiction. I don't know what his mother would have said.
Same as mine when I told her I wanted to turn boxing pro. Now, to be considering it, showed he was already brain damaged beyond hope.
Still, he's put his redundancy money where his mouth is.
But I thought he'd apply for this National Enterprise Allowance, like, and they gave you the cash anyway.
The deal, roughly, is you go to them with a business scheme. If they like it, they'll give you 40 quid a week for a year to help you get it off the ground.
Except?
Yeah, except to qualify for the money you have to have been drawing benefit for at least 8 weeks and have £1,000 in hand.
Yeah, just like that.
Of course, they'll take a bank loan or overdraft facility.
Hey, who wouldn't? It seems a bit strange, though. Money to be a private eye.
Yeah, I know what you mean. There are things that are no-go. Blowing up nuclear installations, opening up sex shops, but producing homemade chocolate, working a vegetable garden, wanting to be a private eye. John reckons they were pretty helpful by and large. Just went to the job centre to find out if he qualified and got himself invited to an awareness day.
Oh yeah, that sounds different.
Videos, financial advice, lunch. Then the other half of the videos, more advice, application forms. And today, the final interview where he takes along proof of the availability of his £1,000.
Lots of difference after all. Just another feast in the new church of Thatcher.
How about you? Anything going?
Can't get a girl, never mind a job. I don't really want to know you when you're out. At least not the sort I like. Hey, you know how Chris is back with me and my mum? She finally left that smooth-talking bastard she was married to.
Wonder what John's reaction will be to that.
Quiet, isn't it?
Not much to shout about in the job centre. Not this side of the counter, anyway.
Quite. Looking for employment yourself. Charlie Rose, by the way.
Oh, John O'Rourke. I'm on this Enterprise allowance wagon. Today's yes or no time.
I'm after some gen on that sort of thing myself.
Aye.
I'm a merchant seaman, but, well, I've had enough one way or another.
Well, you'll have to be an out-of-work merchant seaman to do any good here.
Just on leave, actually. Exploring possibilities.
No go. Out 8 weeks and drawing benefit. I could try them, though. There's always a couple beat the net, no matter how small the mesh. What is it you've got in mind?
Oh, dogs. English setters.
Oh, yeah.
Gentlest things in the world. Take a bone from their mouths. All the virtues of man and none of the vices. How's it go? Or something like that.
You want to breed them? That sort of thing?
Like to set up a kennel.
Oh, I don't think you'll do it for them here. Not without a dole card. That's the Enterprise Allowance idea, you see. Help those who are on the floor but have got access to a bit of money.
And those without access to a bit of money?
Well, they have to help themselves. It's known as the pauper's penalty.
Mr. O'Rourke? Mr. O'Rourke?
It's the container ships, you see. Work and more work. And that bloody Western Ocean. I was used to other things. India, East Africa, the warmth, colour.
Mr. O'Rourke?
Oh, look, I've got to go. Got to get this interview over with.
Of course. Well, best of luck. Oh, I forgot to ask what you're trying for.
Oh, private detective. Like yourself, I'm also after a bit of life. My helping of excitement, warmth and colour.
So then they gave it you?
With due warnings, provisos, and just a hint of blackmail.
Ain't nothing for nothing in this world, John. Hey, having said that, here's a wine gum for nothing.
Doctor.
Ooh, it's getting a bit nippy these mornings. How far now?
I'm just down here.
Moorfields. Prestige address.
Used to be.
Liverpool will come back, don't worry about that. Hey, what did your dad say about leaving home? Getting a flat in town?
Well, he went quiet for a bit. Then asked where it was, who'd had it before me. Told him I thought a painter. He'd left all sorts of weird pictures lying around. Bit of a nutter, maybe.
What did your dad say to that?
That some places attracted him. Then told me to take you in with me. Said he felt I was going to need an ex-scrapper. Anyway, here we are, so you can see for yourself.
Up there? Those stairs?
That penthouse suite. Follow me.
So I asked them to start paying in the 40 a week in a fortnight's time. 1st of October. Stop. This is it.
John, we're higher than the post office tower. How are you going to attract anyone up here?
The Enterprise people went into that. Local paper, local radio, yellow pages. It all comes in the package. Why won't this block open? Did the other day.
Probably sees we're cold at this altitude. Anyway, shouldn't you be able to crack one of those now without leaving any trace?
Curly, be a good lad. Slip down to Dale Street and get me a junior hacksaw, will you? Right. That's it. Now then. Well, what do you think?
Never seen anything like this, John.
I know. Black as a bookie's fingernails.
I was thinking more of it.
Oh, then. Well, you must have seen those painter fellas on the telly and that, surely. That's it with everyone. Cutting their ears off.
If that one leaning on the far wall's anything to go by, it's up their ears need cutting off. Say the priest came round.
Say me dad did.
And that one. Size 40 boob in red. Green eye in the middle of it. Halo over the top. There's no name or nothing.
Have a look on the back.
Oh, so there is. Celestial Vision by Adrian Mintz. That's it then. Celestial Vision by Adrian Mintz. What do you think?
Let's have the mop.
Then ended by hanging around the walls. You should see them.
I don't have to. Where's he kipping?
He sectioned a bit off. Knocked up a partition. With a velvet curtain instead of a door.
Sounds a bit Oscar Wilde to me.
You wouldn't know what to think.
You mightn't. Any custom?
Not a sausage. Just 3 weeks scrubbing and hammering.
What's he doing with himself all day?
He walks around town. Has he been in touch with you?
Rang me to let me know the phone was in. A couple of times since.
And how about you?
At least I've got this place. And the betting shop.
Well, John's got an empty office. So neither of you are getting anywhere. He's not going to ask for help.
We'll give him some, anyway.
Oh, hello, Chris. Oh.
What are you doing here?
Oh, hello, John. Your dad gave me a key.
Oh, right.
Oh, Curly's been coming home with more dust on him than a Jubilee teapot. Bit early for you to be out and about, isn't it?
Oh, I just nipped out for a walk in a paper, you know, same as every morning. Nothing more sinister than that.
Anyway, as you weren't here, I just let myself in. You need to get some decent carpets. Keep the dust down.
I've been trying to sort the bedroom first. Sink, geezer, a few bits of furniture, a mattress.
Your dad thought your old firm might give you one.
How is he?
Seems to spend a lot of time in the pub. We sit and watch the domino players together.
What happened, Chris? I mean, what went wrong?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.